Good afternoon. Good morning. Comment allez-vous? Comment est-ce? Assalamu alaikum. What's up, bro? This is Musa. Matt Meacham Jr. Signing in on Earth. Well, this is interesting. This is so interesting, the things that I discover. The things that I discover every day, the things that I discover on every minute that I exp I'm on this earth. That those of us who are living during this period, we are the fortunate ones. Because during this period, the period that we live in now, it's an important period in the development of mankind. I've organized my books, and I have three books that I'm working on at this point in time. And I was saying, how was I going to be able to get all three of my books? How was I going to be able to publish all three of my books by the end of the year? And plus, I'm also working on a children's play. And I was saying, would I have enough time to meet my deadline? I make my own deadlines. My deadline for three books is the end of the year. And I said, are you serious? Are you going to be able to do that? So what I did was, I got my three books and I organized them. And I found that two of my books are basically completed, and that all that I had to do was to just edit those two books. And the other one, it's gonna take work, because I'm gonna really have to be creative to write the novel. See, I have a novel that I'm writing that takes place in the future. It's called The War Has Begun. And excuse me. And the thing is, I looked at that, I said, that's going to be my challenge. The other two books, it's just a matter of just editing them. So I should be able to complete the three books. I will have to rewrite my children's play. And I hope by the end of the year, I get the right children, I'm gonna finish the children's play. And what I'll do is I will broadcast the children's play over the air, and you will see what kind of work I can do. I was aroused again. I was aroused again. I was editing my novel. And then I went to Google, I think, and there was some type of health warning. In the areas that I work, it said that It started in the, I think the health warning was that it started in the Congo, and it was, and everybody should look out for this particular health warning. The pharaohs are still at work. The pharaohs work 24 hours a day. And perhaps that's why they have been able to control the world. But it's like anything that exists. It's like anything that we know that exists. There is the beginning. There is the development and growth. There is the aging process. And then there is death. Death. We are all, as we exist in this human form, our destiny was written before we came out of our mother's womb. We are born. We mature. And we die. Those are the laws of the universe in which we live in. Perhaps in other universes, and that I would not doubt that there are other universes where you have organisms or lives that live, that exist forever. But here on Earth, there are few things, if there are any, that exist forever in the form in which they are contained. What am I saying? I'm talking about a sociological issue. I'm talking about a political issue. I'm talking about a philosophical issue. I am talking about a human issue. My thoughts that at this period in time, for the human being that exists in our universe, for the human being that exists here on Earth, that a big change is coming, that a big change has already come. Let's look at it. Let's look at what I'm talking about. I can only go back as far as I know. Okay, I am a black man who lives in USA on occasion. As I look at the things that are happening in the whole world, when I look and see the things that are happening in USA, when I look and see the things which are happening in Africa, I see a big change coming. A big change is in the making. And there are some who do not want that change to come. And there are some who even try to prevent that change from coming. But see, there's one thing about our universe. This universe, which we live in, human beings, we are born, we develop, we die. And that seems to be consistent with all of the living things that we know that exist in our universe. What is happening in our universe? Unless a lot of things happen in our universe, but let's look at things that are happening on Earth. Let's look at things that are happening on Earth. Okay. I remember growing up in Alabama, USA, that if I could not ride a bus unless I walked to the back of the bus. I remember that my father, and I was only young, that when he took us to get ice cream, yes, my father had to drive his car into the back of the ice cream place to get ice cream for us. We could not go in the front. These are things that I remember. I remember when I was a university student. Okay, now, I graduated first in my class in the school that I went to in Alabama. And I went to a school called Tufts University. And I remember that I sat in a drama class. I was taking a course at the university. And I was sitting in the class, in a drama class. And I was, you know, happened to be the only black sitting in the class. And this grown man professor, noticing that I'm sitting, this young man, he said, "Even a Negro can make it in drama." Okay. I'm only just looking at some of the things that I remember as a child, as a young man. So I grew and matured and traveled and wrote and have written over 500 books, yes, published, over 500 books at this point in time. And I look at the world, and I see where the world was, and I see where the world is, and I see where the world is going. Do you think that God is going to allow Israel to do what it's doing to those Palestinian people? Do you think God is going to allow that to continue? Do you think that, okay, the Western civilization beat down the African civilization and whipped our behind? There was a reason for that. There was a reason for that. The question is, why did God allow those Western Europeans to go into our lands and whip our behinds and take our lands and our wealth? And they still do it today. Why has God allowed that to happen? Corruption, immorality. What was our behavior? What were we doing when these guys came from way up north and took our lands and whipped our behinds and took our wealth and ruled Africa and black people for centuries? Why did God allow that to happen? Okay. It's interesting how the paradox exists. Let's look at this youthful generation that's popping up. Just popping up. It's a paradox that even though this youthful population has popped up and rebelled against its elders, but the question is, what are the elders doing? Corruption is a fact. And sometimes we have to deal with certain things. We have to be harsh. For instance, let's put ourselves in a child's place. And the mother says, don't do this. And the mother says, don't do that. But then the child still does what the mother says, don't do. So if she's a concerned mother, she has to discipline that child so that that child will understand not to do that. So she may have to give him a spanking and he has to cry. She has to hurt him. She has to put him in pain to make him understand. Let's see what obedience means and who is the one who's demanding the obedience. Okay, the mother knows that if that child walks into the street, that a car is a possibility that a car will hit that child. It will harm that child, hurt that child, or kill that child. The mother knows that. So she tells the child not to walk into the street, and the child walks into the street. So for that child to understand that he should not walk in the street, she gives him one of the worst weapons of his life. And that child will remember that if he goes in the street, he knows that he is going to get a serious punishment. But look what the mother has to do and consider why she has to do it. She has to give him pain, and she gives him pain because she loves him. It's ironic. It's a paradox. She whips his behind. She whips his behind bad. Because she knows that if he goes out in the street, a car is going to hit him. And he will never forget when she put that whipping on him. That child is going to remember, better not go back in the streets like that. So sometimes it takes pain for us to go in the right direction. So when those young people became prey to the colonial masters, and they came out and rebelled against the institution, they burned down the cities. They burnt down the government facilities. They were totally disorderly. But maybe it took that strain, it took that expression to say to their parents that you are doing the wrong thing. So they become tools of the enemy. The enemy. Who is the enemy? Who is the enemy? What is the enemy? Where is the enemy? This is Musa, Matt Meacham Jr., signing out on Earth.